All right, it's Thursday, the 29th of April, 2010, and this is your Daily Dose. And I've got some quotes today, and they're from basically Ayn Rand, and that is a Russian female writer. And the first question says, "A creative man is motivated by the desire to achieve, not by the desire to beat others." The second quote says, "I don't build in order to have clients. I have clients in order to build." The next quote says, "The question isn't who is going to let me, it's who is going to stop me." And I have a whole page, so I'm just going to keep ripping them. The next says, "The smallest minority on earth is the individual. Those who deny individual rights cannot claim to be defenders of minorities. Potentially, a government is the most dangerous threat to man's rights. It holds a legal monopoly on the use of physical force against legally disarmed victims. Only the man who does not need it is fit to inherit wealth. The man who would make his fortune no matter where he started." So, you think that money is the root of all evil? Have you ever asked what is the root of all money? The man who lets a leader prescribe his course is a wreck being towed to the scrap heap. The truth is not for all men, but only for those who seek it. And wealth is the product of man's capacity to think. And here's the last one and my favorite. People create their own suggestions because they are afraid to look straight. All you have to do is look straight and see the road. And when you see it, don't sit looking at it. Walk. All right, and what we're going to talk about today after our quotes is we're going to talk about jury nullification. And I'm just going to read this little article and then another thing I want to read to you. If you actually Google jury nullification in the Constitution, the number one choice should be this 13-page article. And I'm going to read something that's from page 4 on it. But we're going to start right here. This is off the site from yesterday. For those of you who can remember, we have the FIJA.org. That was the site from yesterday, FIJA.org. And this came from that site. And it says, "The Washington Post published a front page story entitled, 'In Jury Rooms, a Form of Civil Protest Grows Last Year.' According to the Post article, jurors are not always following judges' instructions to the letter. The article recounted that sometimes in jury trials, when those facts which the judge chooses to allow into evidence indicate that defendant broke the law, jurors look at the facts quite differently from the way the judge instructed them to. The jurors do not say, 'On the basis of these facts, the defendant is guilty.' Instead, the jurors say, 'On the basis of these facts, the law is wrong,' and they vote to acquit. Or they may vote to acquit because they believe the law is being unjustly applied, or because some government conduct in the case has been so egregious that they cannot reward it with a conviction. In short, a passion for justice invades the jury room. The jurors begin judging the law and government as well as the facts, and they render their verdict according to conscience. This is called jury nullification." I'm getting goosebumps. Goosebumps. Goosebumps, just the energy that I get when I talk about this. So I want to go ahead and read this another part about it. And this is just an outtake from an article that's basically called "Jury Nullification, the Top Secret Constitutional Right" by James Joseph Duane. All right? So we're going to go to page 4 of this. And on page 4, first column towards the bottom, I'm just going to start reading, and it says, "This widespread judicial pattern is highly ironic. The courts have unanimously and erroneously refused to let defense attorneys argue for nullification, typically by insisting that the jury has no power to consider what the law should be, and that the juries have no lawful task but to decide whether the defendant broke the law. Yet, in a fit of sheer inconsistency, the same federal court of appeals are also unanimous that it is permissible for prosecutors to urge juries to act as the conscience of the community and use their verdict to send a message about whether society should be willing to tolerate the defendant's alleged conduct." All right? And then it And then it says, the Sixth Amendment creates a right for the defendant to insist on a jury to act as a community conscience and protect him from government oppression. And yet only the state is allowed, when it chooses, to ask the jury to consider matters of morality and conscience. Thus, have we witnessed a complete perversion of the constitutional priorities and structure? One might fairly summarize the case law this way. You may hope that the jury will refuse to apply a harsh, unfair, or inequitable law, but you may not urge them to do so. But why not? Why can't we tell the jury a little bit more than we do about the truth? Not since storming of the Bastille have the forces of government been so tightly united in their opposition to a popular uprising. Numerous arguments have been advanced by judges around the country for this refusal, but one stands up to serious analysis. And here's number one, and I'm only going to read this number one. It says, jury nullification is an embarrassing glitch in our law. And that was in quotes. What should we tell jurors about their power to nullify? The answer depends largely on one's attitude towards a closely related issue. Just what is nullification anyway? And why is it protected by the Constitution? One of the most frequent justifications for refusing to tell juries about their power to nullify is the pernicious suggestion that this power is the product of some accidental or regrettable flaw in our system of justice. Jury nullification has been described in many ways, some of which cannot be repeated in respectable society. At one extreme, a federal judge recently hailed it as one of the peaceful barricades of freedom, considering jury nullification. Even courts declining to instruct juries about the doctrine have conceded that the pages of history shine on instances of the jury's exercise of its prerogative to disregard uncontradicted evidence and instructions of the judge. Now, on the other hand, some courts have suggested that the power to nullify is merely a tolerated anomaly in the rule of law. Well, here's the deal. It's an anomaly that's going to start showing up more and more often, especially as it pertains to cannabis-related charges within the community, especially within the state of Nevada. It's already happening within states of California, Colorado, Michigan, New Mexico, Hawaii, Maryland. All these states that have medical marijuana pros, we're seeing more and more cases where patients are winning in the courtroom, and it's producing an unneeded burden through the war on drugs, so on, the big web. We all know what it is. We've been dealing with it for nothing. It's just nonsense. Every day that goes by, and I keep saying this all the time, that everybody who watches this video doesn't forward it to one of our elected officials so that they can realize that they're elected officials, they're responsible for basically doing what we ask of them, representing the people. And right now, no matter what we do, the people are telling them, hey, legalize, let's make sense of this medically, however you want to do it. But because of ignorance, that's right, ignorance, straight stupidity about hemp, cannabis, just lack of just straight common sense knowledge that's available in an encyclopedia, the emperor wearing nose clothes. There's so many sources out there to get our own government produced hemp for freedom. I mean, come on. Are you serious? We live in the most ignorant industrialized country that there is. That's all I can say. We're a nation that's supposed to be a nation that's free. But yet, I have to do videos to hopefully instruct people about the rights of the juries. Because why? Because in the state of Nevada, I'm going to face an unjust law at some point unless we can change it. And the fact is I can't afford another one of our clients or patients to die before safe access and the right to learn things that they should be allowed to learn in an environment that's safe and one in which they're willing to do business in. In other words, if someone is willing to pay me, that's a licensed patient, to teach them certain things, I should be allowed to conduct that business because I'm a licensed patient in the state of Nevada. It shouldn't take this long to get decisions on things. So, with that being said, a little bit of rant in there, I apologize. I just want people to know what jury nullification is, read this information, and please, today, devote at least the next 10 minutes, 15 minutes, veg yourself in this literature. Learn more about jury nullification, because when you find yourself in jury duty, hopefully, if I show up in front of you and I've done something that just is unjust or isn't covered, if I break the law, convict me. But if I broke an unsound and unjust law, please, please do what you're supposed to do. Be a jury of my peers and judge the facts for yourself. All right, everybody, this was Thursday, April the 29th, 2010, and this was your Daily Dose.